Good afternoon and welcome to St. John the Baptist Catholic Parish in Costa Mesa, California, to our Holy Mass in the Extraordinary Form, our Latin Mass. Today's Holy Mass is for the 6th Sunday after Pentecost. Blessed and joyful July 4th to everyone as well. Here are the announcements. They're very brief. Tomorrow, the 5th, is the observance of the holiday at the parish. So tomorrow, July 5th, Monday, there will be adoration in the church from 7:45 a.m. to 8:45 a.m., followed by the one and only Mass of the day, the 9 a.m. Mass tomorrow morning. So tomorrow, Monday, 7:45 to 8:45 a.m. adoration in the church. At 9 a.m. Mass, the only Mass of the day. There will be no other Masses, prayers. There's no afternoon adoration, no confessions, and the parish office will be closed. So any other announcements, and always check our website, take a bulletin for other announcements as well. Today's Holy Mass is for the intention of Joseph Molina. And now the prayer to St. Michael the Archangel. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Asperges me. Thank you. Ostende nobis Domine misericordiam tuam. Domine exaudi oratione mea. Dominus vobiscum. Oremus, exaudi nos Domine Sancte Pater Omnipotens Eterne Deus, et Mater Digneris Sanctum Angelum Tuum de Celis, qui custodiat foviat protegat, visiteratque defendat omnes habitantes in hoc habitaculo, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Fortitudo plena.
gloria in excelsis Deo. Dominus vobiscum,
et vos spiritus
oremus, Deus virtutum cuius est totum quod est optimum, incere pectoribus nostres amorem tui nominis, et preso in nobis religionis augmentum, utque sunt bona nutrias, ac pietatis studioque sunt nutrita custodias, per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum Filium Tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Lectio Epistulae Beati Pauli Apostoli ad Romanos. Fratres, quicumque baptizati sumus in Christu Iesu, in morte ipsius baptizati sumus. Consepulti enim sumus cum illo per baptismum in mortem, ut quo modo Christus surrexit a mortuis per gloriam Patris, ita et nos in novitate vitae ambulemus. Si enim complantanti facti sumus similitudini mortis eius, simul et resurrectionis erimus. Hoc scientes, quia vetus homo noster simul crucifixus est, ut destruatur corpus peccati, et ultra non serviamus peccato. Qui enim mortuus est, justificatus est a peccato. Si autem mortui sumus cum Christo, credimus quia simul etiam vivemus cum Christo. Scientes quod Christus resurgens ex mortuis, jam non moritur, mor illi ultra non dominabitur. quod enim mortuus est peccato, mortuus est semel, quod autem vivit, vivit Deo. Ita et vos extitamete vos mortuus quidem esse peccato, viventes autem Deo, in Christu Jesu Domino nostro.
Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spiritu tuo.
Sequentiae Sancti Evangelii secundum Marcum.
Gloria tibi, Domine.
In illo tempore cum turba multa esset cum Iesu, nec haberens quod mandu carens, convocatis discipulis ait illis, miserior super turbam qui ecce iam trido sustinens me, nec haben quod manducent, et si de misero es iunus in domum suam, deficient in via, quidam enim ex esto longe venerunt, et responderunt ei discipuli sui, unde illos quis poteret hic saturare panibus in solitudine, et interrogavit eos, quod panes habetis, quid ixerunt septem, et precepit turbe discumbere super terra, et accipiens septem panes, gratias agens fregit, et dabat discipulis suis ut apponerens, et appusuerunt turbe. Et habebat pisciculos paucos, et ipsos benedixit, et iusit apponit. Et manducaverunt et saturati sunt, et sustulerunt quod superaverat de fragmentis, septem sportas. Erant autem qui manducaverans, quasi quatuor milia et dimisit eius. Our nation this weekend, today, celebrates its freedom. What comes to your mind when you hear the word freedom? In the minds of some people, freedom means without any restraint, doing whatever you want. If all of us were to do whatever we want, there would be anarchy and chaos, not freedom and order. In his letter to the Galatians, St. Paul wrote that we are all called for freedom. He went on to make sure that we know that freedom is not giving in to every urge or impulse we experience. Freedom is not doing whatever we want, but doing whatever we should that gives honor to God and serves the spiritual and physical well-being of our neighbor. The 4th of July is a day of parades, political speeches, fireworks, and backyard barbecues. But most of all, it is a day of celebrating our nation's independence. An independence that was won and is maintained by the sacrifice of many lives. We need to remember that we are celebrating an independence that is not absolute. Adam, the first man deceived by Satan, thought that he could possess absolute independence, and we are still suffering from the effects of his mistake. True independence is rooted in our dependence on God. We are contingent, dependent beings. Only God has absolute independence. That is why the first commandment is also the greatest commandment. Only when we are completely dependent on God do we then have true freedom. And this dependence on God is clearly stated in our nation's Declaration of Independence. It begins thus: we hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, and that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights. And it ends with a firm reliance on divine providence, we pledge our lives, our fortunes, and our honor. Our nation was founded on belief in God. The president takes his oath of office by placing his hand on the Bible and ends with, "So help me God." In our Pledge of Allegiance, we say, "One nation under God." And engraved on our money is, "In God we trust." Our Congress, as a chaplain, begins its session with a prayer and provides for chaplains for the military. Our founding fathers may have opted for a separation of church and state, but not for a separation of God and state. There can be no brotherhood of man without the fatherhood of God. The division of life into the sacred and the secular is a false dichotomy. There is not now, there never was, and there never will be the purely secular. That is anyone or anything that is completely independent of God. Atheistic capitalism would suffer the same fate as atheistic communism. There are people in our society who have no religious affiliation and who consider religion useless, superstitious, antiquated, and even harmful. What the Constitution guarantees is not freedom from religion, but freedom of religion, freedom to practice our faith. The irony, the contradiction, is that those who are pushing for freedom from religion are actually pushing their own peculiar religion, which is secular humanism. In secular humanism, the supreme being is man. And history has seen many men who thought themselves as supreme beings and acted with absolute power. And what type of men were they? Were they not greedy, lustful, and proud? As we have had to defend our freedom as a nation many times in order to preserve it, so we have to continue defending our freedom, our liberty as a religious people. It is both our right and duty. Many Christians, many Catholics have great anxiety and fear concerning our current leaders and our future leaders. But we must maintain our hope and faith. The words of John F. Kennedy are apropos. In his inaugural address in 1960, he encouraged us, quote, "With a good conscience, our only sure reward, with history, the final judge of our deeds, let us go forth to lead the land we love, asking God's blessing and help, knowing that here on earth, God's work must truly be our own."
Credo in unum Deum,
Thank you.
Dominus vobiscum. Oremus.
Perfice, in
per omnia saecula saeculorum. Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Sursum corda. Gratias agamus, Domino Deo nostro. Vere dignum et justum es ecum et salutare, nos tibi semper ut ubique, gratias agere. Domine Sancte Pater Omnipotens, Eterne Deus, qui cum unigenito Filio Tuo, et Spiritus Sancto unus est Deus, unus est Dominus, non in unius singularitate personae, sed in unius Trinitate substantiae. Quod enim de tua gloria revelante te credimus, hoc de Filio tuo, hoc de Spiritu Sancto, sine differentia discretionis sentimus. Ut in confessione vere semper te neque deitatis, et in personis proprietas, et in essentia unitas, et in maestate adoretur equalitas. Quam laudat angeli atque arcangeli, cherubim quoque ac seraphim, qui non cessant clamare quotidie, una voce dicentes. Sanctus, 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 sanctus.
Thank you.
nobis quoque peccatoribus. Per omnia saecula saeculorum. Oremus, precepti salutaribus moniti, et divina institutione formati, audemus dicere, Pater noster, qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimite nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimitimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem. Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Thank you.
Mysteria tua vestri omnipotens Deus et dimissis peccatis vestris producat vos ad vitam aeternam. Indulgentiam absolutionem et remissionem peccatorum vestorum tribuat vobis omnipotens et misericus Dominus. Ecce agnus Dei, ecce qui tollit peccata mundi, Domine non sum dignus, et inter esse tectum meum, sed tantum dic verbo et sanabitur anima mea. Domine non sum dignus, et inter esse tectum meum, sed tantum dic verbo et sanabitur anima mea. Domine non sum dignus, et inter esse tectum meum, sed tantum dic verbo et sanabitur anima mea. Dominus vobiscum. Oremus. Repletissimus Domine muneribus suis, tribue quesimus ut eorum et mundemur effectu, et muniamur auxilio. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Ite missa est. Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.